Yes, welcome back to the next session of Design of Pre-Stressed Concrete Elements course. So in the last session, we were discussing regarding the stress concept and the problems we have been discussed in connection with the stress concept. So let us today go ahead with the load balancing concept or the concept of load balancing. Okay, from this particular session. So let us proceed. So what is that? What exactly is load balancing concept? Okay, and what are the things we need to consider here? So let us know one by one. So it is possible to select a suitable cable profile in a PAC member such that the transverse component of the cable force balance the given type of external loads. I will repeat, it is possible to select suitable cable profile in a PAC member such that the transverse component of the cable force balance the given type of external loads. So what I want to explain here is, consider a PAC beam. If PSC beam is subjected to any external load, so based on the external load, I am going to provide the cable inside the pre-stressed concrete beam in such a way that so those cable will induce certain amount of force, so which balance the external load. So that is what the meaning of load balancing concept. So whatever the the stresses created by the external loads, the stresses created external load will be counteracted and will be nullified by the suitable cable profile. A very important thing, suitable cable profile. Okay, so that suitable cable profile will induce a transfer forces, that is in perpendicular direction. So those forces will try to balance the external loads. So this is what the meaning of a load balancing concept. So let us know this. So this can be readily illustrated by considering the free body of a concrete with a tendon replaced by a forces acting on the concrete beam as shown in the figure and the table. So let us see them. So please observe here, very carefully. So I'm going to explain the concept. See, this is a concrete beam, a PSC concrete beam, a pre-stressed concrete beam, and this will be the the centroidal axis. This will be the centroidal axis of the beam, and this is the cable they have been placed. So this is the cable they have been placed. Okay, so it is a straight cable. Please observe this. It is a straight cable. Okay, and next, this will be there of certain amount of eccentricity. Let me denote it by H. In load balancing concept, we are not going to call it as eccentricity. We used to call it as dip of the cable. The H will be designated by dip of the cable. Instead of eccentricity, I used to call it as dip of the cable. While in the stress concept, we used to call it as eccentricity. But in this particular load balancing concept, I used to say it is a dip of the cable. And the dip of the cable is denoted by H. And the next, so this is the pre-stressing force induced. Please observe it is a eccentric pre-stressing. That means the cable is placed away from the central axis. And this is the span L. This is the span here. So now what important thing we need to observe here is, so this whatever the pre-stressing force induced will try to create a, okay, the moment, okay, at the left hand side, which will create an anti-clockwise moment, and the right hand side will create a clockwise moment. That means, so this particular pre-stressing force will tend to create a moment, okay, or tend to create a forces upwards in such a way that whatever the external load that will be acting on the beam will try to resist or will be nullified by this stride cable. So that is what the concept of this stride cable profile. And you can see the equivalent moment, that is M is equal to P multiplied by H. In the stress concept, I used to say it is a P multiplied by E. But here you can see, since it is a dip of the cable, I will say M is equal to P multiplied by H. Is it clear? And the corresponding cable, or I can say the deflection, is ML square by 8EI. Okay, so you don't need to worry about this fourth one. Okay, let us go with these three columns. So next, let us go with one more typical example. You can see here. So this is a PSC beam. Okay, please observe very carefully. It's a PSC beam. Now, this particular beam, please observe. So let me draw this PSC beam. The same thing I'm going to draw. See, this PSC beam will be subjected to central concentrated load. Let me call this as W. Okay, so this will be your external load. Okay, it will be subjected to W. Okay, so this will be subjected to W, and this will be the centroidal axis. So now we know that when the beam is subjected to central concentrated load, okay, you know what, how will be the bending moment diagram? How will be the bending moment diagram? The bending moment diagram will be like this. Am I right? Okay. And as we know that, okay, the central, okay, concentrated load will create a maximum bending moment, okay, at mid span. Okay. Hence, this moment will be WL by 4. So this basics you know from the structure analysis. So this will be WO, okay, WO L WO L divided by 4. Okay, so this is the basics, and this is the shape of the bending moment diagram you are going to get if the beam is subjected to central concentrated load. So now come to this diagram. So please observe here. Okay, so in order to counteract the external load, I am going to put a linear cable, or I can say bent tendon. So this is called bent tendon. Okay, so this bent tendon will be placed. So this bent tendon will be placed, okay, in order to counteract the external load. So this particular, so because you please observe here, I have been told suitable cable profile. What is the meaning of this suitable cable profile? See, so when the beam is subjected to central concentrated load, then we are going to use this particular shape of cable profile. Why? Because this external load will create a, bending moment in this particular diagram or in this particular shape. So hence, okay, reversible of this bending moment diagram will be the shape of the cable profile I'm going to put inside the concrete beam to counteract the central concentrated load. Is it clear? So that's what I'm meaning, what I want to say. So please now read the definition. Suitable cable profile is provided in a PSC member such that the transverse component, that means that cable will induce a force to balance the given type of external load. So now it is central concentrated load. So in order to balance this, I'm going to provide bent tendons. Is it clear? So this is what the way, okay, the load balancing concept will come into the picture. So in order to balance the central concentrated external load, I have been provided the bent end on or a suitable cable profile in this particular shape. So this shape will depend upon the bending moment diagram of that particular load. Is it clear? So now, as I stated, so this will become H, okay, or dip of the cable, dip of the cable. Okay, so now we can see the bending moment, the central bending moment diagram. Okay, the magnet span moment is WL by 4. Okay, next, we'll go to the WC. What is the meaning of WC? So WC means this cable will induce, as I stated, an upward force. Okay, this cable will induce an upward force. Okay, so this load, okay, transmitted by a cable upwards, a load transmitted by a cable upwards will be designated by WC. That is what C indicates, cable upward load transmitted by the cable to balance the downward external load. So that is what the meaning of WC. I will repeat, WC is the upward forces or load, okay, transmitted by a cable or created by a cable to counteract or nullify the external load. Okay, so that external load will be acting in the downward direction. Is it clear? So now, how to calculate this upward load transmitted by the cable? So that is WC is equal to 4 multiplied by M by L, where M is, we know, P into H. That is precessing force multiplied by dip of the cable. Hence, it is 4PH by L. Is it clear? Okay, so let us take one more example. See, once again, consider, okay, a PSC beam. Okay, the same PSC beam. Okay. Now, I've been provided with a parabolic cable. Why? So the parabolic cable will come into the picture once the beam is subjected to UDL. Okay, that is WO. So when the beam is subjected to external load, okay, we know what is the bending moment diagram. The bending moment diagram will be parabola, and this will be the mid-span moment. Okay, so we know that when the beam carries the uniformly distributed load whose intensity is same throughout the span, then the maximum bending moment will come at mid-span. And this maximum bending at mid-span is this WO, okay, into L square divided by 8. WO L square by 8. Okay, so now let us come to this. So as I stated, when the beam is subjected to the external load, see, the shape of the BMD will be parabola. Hence, I'm going to provide the cable, okay, in the same fashion, that is parabolic cable. So when the beam is subjected to external, that is UDL load, then the shape of the best suitable, okay, shape or profile of the cable, okay, we need to provide is parabola. So this parabola cable or parabolic cable will counteract the external UDL effectively. Is it clear? So that is what the meaning load balancing concept. If I want to balance this load or external load, I need to provide a suitable cable profile to counteract the stresses created by the external load. So that is what the meaning load balancing concept. Okay, so once again, okay, So come to this, as we know, M is equal to W L square by 8, WC once again. So WC means the load transmitted or force, okay, or upward pressure created by the cable. So this is what upward pressure. So this is the upward pressure created by the cable. Okay, when this cable is pulled and induced the pre-stressing force. So this is what your WOC. So this WOC will try to counteract the external load W, so that the stresses will be minimized in the PSCB or nullified in the PSCB. Hence, WOC is equal to same thing, 8 into M, that is 8 into PH divided by L square. So this is the, okay, the load or upward load transmitted by the cable. Is it clear? Next, let us go with one more example. Next, when the beam is subjected to, okay, when the beam is subjected to two-point loading, okay, two-point loading. So when the beam is subjected to two-point loading, so that is, let me call W, whose intensity is same at both. That means, so at this, okay, this point load is also W and this is also W. Okay, at this instance, it will create a bending moment out like this. Am I right? So in this particular way, it will create a bending moment. Okay, so at this particular, under the point load, the intensity or maximum bending moment will be created, or it will be more. So now, okay, based on this, okay, here also I'm going to provide, okay, the cable profile like this. So when the beam is subjected to two-point load, okay, I'm going to provide the shape of the cable profile like this. And as I stated, this will be the dip of the cable, that is H. Okay, dip of the cable H, and this will be the span, okay, L, and this will be the, okay, A, this will be A, okay, and from this it is also A, okay, A. Is it clear? So now the upward force transmitted by the cable is the same thing. So this is what the same thing, okay. So this is what WC, and the formula is A into, okay, M by L, or A into PH by L. Okay, so this is what the formula for upward force transmitted by the cable. So like this, okay, the load or external load will be balanced, or will try to balance, by this tendon or a cable. Okay, and as I stated, the load balancing concept means if you want to balance the external load, okay, we need to provide the cable profile based upon the external load it has been subjected. Okay, so that cable profile will depend upon the shape of the bending moment diagram. Is it clear? So this is regarding your load balancing concepts. So let us know further. So that's what, so whatever the thing I've been discussed here, the same thing has been explained. So the various types of reactions of a cable upon a concrete member depends upon shape of the cable profile. Straight portion of the cable induce, the straight portion of the cable do not induce any reaction except at the ends, while curved cables results in uniformly distributed loads. Sharp cape angles in a cable induced concentrated loads. So that's what I've been told. So this is the sharp angles, and this is the curved cables, okay, and this is the straight cable, okay. The concept of load balancing is useful in selecting the tendon profile, which can supply the most desirable system of forces. Why? Okay, this desirable system of forces transmitted by the tendon. Why? To balance the external load. Okay, in general, this requirement will be satisfied if the cable profile in a PSC member corresponds to the shape of the bending moment diagram resulting from the external load. That's what I've been told. The shape of the cable profile will be satisfied based upon the PSC member subjected to external load and its bending moment diagram. So this is regarding your load balancing concept. Hope the concept has been clarified. Okay. So now, based upon this load balancing concept, let us work out some problem. Okay, this load balancing concept have been bifurcated into three sections or discretized into three sections. I am going to calculate the stresses using load balancing concept in three profiles or in four profiles, I can say. Okay, so the first one is I am going to calculate the stresses, okay, using load balancing concept in straight tendon. So this is the first thing I will do. Later on, I'm going to calculate the stresses, okay, in PSC beam using load balancing concept for parabolic cable. That is second concept. Next, I'm going to work out the problems on, okay, calculating the stresses using load balancing concept for bent tendons. That is the next thing. And also miscellaneous or typical problem I'm also going to solve with respect to two-point loading. So for all this shape of a cable profile, let us work out the problem. Let us calculate this WC, all those things. And later on, finally, we are going to arrive with the stresses using load balancing concept. So let us proceed. Okay, so let me start first with, okay, the straight profile. So let me go ahead with the straight profile. I will start with the stride profile now, so that the concept will be clarified. Okay, so let me go ahead with this stride profile. Okay, so the heading says tendons with stride profile or stride tendons. Okay, now let me go ahead. The figure shows a PSC beam, fine, carries external UDL shear. It carries external load, that is WL. Please note down, instead of WQ, as I stated in the stress concept, same thing. Okay, I can use it WL. So that means this is also called as WL. Okay, WL. Okay. So this WL is called live load, which is UDL, okay, that has been distributed throughout the beam, full stop. The tendon is provided with a stride profile, fine. So this is the stride profile. When the cable is provided with a stride profile, it will exert a uniform upward pressure, WC meter per run on the beam. You can see here, that's what I've been told. So once, if I want to balance this external load which is acting on the beam, then this whatever the stride cable which has been put inside the cable, okay, next, then next, this particular cable, okay, this cable will induce a upward reaction. So that upward force or upward load transmitted by the cable is denoted by WC. Please note, please, because all these nomenclature are very, very, very important. WL indicates external load acting on the beam. WC indicates load transmitted by the stride cable to counteract or nullify the external loads. Is it clear? Fine. Next, let me go ahead further. So this is what the formula. So the horizontal reaction, because please see here. Okay. So this, what I can say, the P resisting force which has been induced, okay, will try to create a, or can be resolved into two forces. One is Px, okay, and another one is Py. So this is the forces I am going to resolve on both the sides. Okay, so that Px, that is the horizontal component, horizontal reaction at each end of the cable equal to, so we know this formula, W L square by 8H, or W is equal to 8PH by L square. So how we need to arrive with this formula, I've already been explained to you. Okay, so this formula, okay, will be come across based upon the bending moment. As we know that M is equal to W L square by 8, or W is equal to 8 into M divided by L square, or 8 into, where M is the PH, P into H by L square. And please note down a very important thing, here H will be called as dip of the cable. There is a lot of difference between dip of the cable and eccentricity. Please note this point. In load balancing concept, I used to call it as dip of the cable. Instead of calling eccentricity, I used to call it as dip of the cable. So this is what the dip of the cable. Okay, this is what dip of a cable, H. Okay, so now please observe a very important thing. The net downward load acting on the beam. The net downward load acting on the beam. So please note here, WOD, that is G means W dead load plus live load minus intensity. Please observe here. See, if the PSC beam, okay, if you consider the PSC beam, so this PSC beam will be subjected to two external loads. One is live load and another one is internally developed dead load. Okay, so live load and dead load will try to create or try to act as an external load. So these two external load will be counterbalanced by the WC. Okay, so now what I want to explain here is, so this downward load which is acting, which will be positive, okay, and the upward load or upward force created by the cable which is negative. So this is the sign convention. Okay, the downward load which is acting on the PSC beam, that is dead load and live load, will be positive, and the upward force transmitted by the cable in order to counteract this will be negative. So whatever the value you are going to obtain, so that will be the net downward. Why I'm going to call it downward? Because, okay, this WD and WL intensity will be more as compared to the WC. Hence, I used to call it as downward load. So this you will come to know more once I am going to solve the problem. Okay, so that's why the meaning downward load. That means the effect of dead load and live load is more as compared to the forces created by the cable. But this upward force transmitted by the cable will try to minimize. Is it clear? Fine. So based on this concept, let us work out the problem, one problem. So we'll come to know what actually is the strike. So let me consider a PSC beam. Okay. So let me consider the PSC beam. (400 by 600 millimeter) in section. As a span of 6 meter, a PSC beam 400 by 600 millimeter in section. That means it is a rectangular section. As a span of 6 meter, and it is subjected to uniformly distributed load of 16 kilonewton per meter, including the sulfate of the beam. Please note this point. So whatever this PSC beam, okay, has been given, so this PSC beam has been subjected to the external load 16 kilonewton per meter, okay, which includes self weight of the beam also. That means it comprises 16 kilonewton mean both dead load, that is WD plus WL, is equal to 16 kilonewton per meter. Full stop. The pre-stressing tendons, which are located along the longitudinal centroidal axis. Okay, so please note down, instead of giving it as a straight cable or straight tendon, so they have been given in this fashion. That is pre-stressing tendons, which are located along the longitudinal centroidal axis. That means parallel to the centroidal axis of the section. Provides an effective pre-stressing force of 960 kilonewton. Full stop. Determine the extreme fiber stresses at mid-span section using load balancing concept. Is it clear? So what are the things you need to observe here? First, you please observe, what is the section? It is a rectangular section. Span is how much? 66 meter. And it is subjected to UDL of 16 kilonewton per meter, which includes self weight of the beam also. That means it comprises of both dead load and live load. Very important thing. And the next thing is longitudinal, which are located along the long, that means it is straight profile, pre-stressed with a pre-stressing force of 960 kilonewton. Okay, so now determine the extreme fiber stresses where? Mid-span section using load balancing concept. So this is what the problem they have been given. So how to proceed? Let us see. So now, so this is the PSC beam, okay, whose span is 6 meter. This is the longitudinal section. It has been subjected to the external load, that is WD plus WL, okay, because this 16 kilonewton per meter, which comprises of both dead load and live load. And please note down, the pre-stressing tendon, which are located along the longitudinal, that means, so this cable, which is, okay, induced through the centroidal axis with a pre-stressing force of 960. So that is what the meaning, along the longitudinal centroidal axis, along the centroidal axis, okay. And this is the cross section of the beam. Okay, so that is 400 by 600. So how to proceed with the problem? So let us calculate first the cross sectional area as usual. So 400 multiplied by 600, B multiplied by D. So that is 24 into 10 to the power of 4 millimeter square. Next, pre-stressing force as usual 960 kilonewton. Next, second moment of area, that is I, or moment of inertia I, is equal to BD cube by 12. We know that because for a rectangular section, the moment of inertia is BD cube by 12. Okay, that is 400 into 600 cube by 12. And the answer is 7.2 into 10 to the power of 9 millimeter to the power of 4. And the next, coming to this Y, that is, okay, that is Y top and Y bottom. So this is the, okay, Y top and Y bottom. So this will be same. Y it will be same because it is a symmetrical section. Hence, Y top or Y bottom will be equal to 600 by 2, which is equal to 300. Next, a very important thing, eccentricity is zero. Why it is zero? Because our dip of the cable, instead of E, I can say H. Dip of the cable or eccentricity is zero. Why? Because the whatever the cable I'm inducing, okay, so that cable will be induced along the centroidal axis, through the centroidal axis, hence it is zero. Is it clear? Next, Z. Z is equal to I divided by Y, 7.2 into 10 to the power of 9 divided by 300, which workouts to be 24 into 10 to the power of 6 millimeter cube. Okay, next. Coming to the dead load and live load, that is WD plus WL, which is 16 kilonewton per meter. Next, as I stated, let us calculate the upward load intensity, because we know the external load which is acting downward. Now we want to know the WC. What is the meaning of WC? Load transmitted by the cable, okay, in upward direction, or upward force transmitted by the cable, okay, which is given by 8 pH by L square. Why? Because, okay, if the beam is subjected to the external load, okay, that is UDL, okay, the formula will be given by 8 pH by L square. Okay, so this formula will be based on, okay, the external load. So now substitute this 8 into, okay, since we want the answer in kilonewton, I will retain the pre-stressing force. I'll substitute the pre-stressing force in kilonewton only. So 960 multiply by H. So as I stated, the dip of the cable is zero. Okay, H or, okay, the dip of the cable is zero because the cable is passing through the central axis, divided by 6 square, which will be zero only. Next, net downward load intensity. So let me call it by capital W. Okay, because, okay, you can see W, so no need to get confused. So hence you can call it as capital W. So capital W is equal to WD plus WL, that is the load, okay, exerted by, okay, or the load acting downward, okay, or external load acting downward on the PCB, minus the load transmitted by the cable. So that is, substituting this, 16 will be the external load, minus 0 will be the upward load, because, okay, the upward force will induce 0 kilonewton per meter. Hence, the net downward load intensity will be 16 kilonewton per meter. You can see the net effect of, okay, this downward load is more. Hence, it is called net downward load intensity. Okay, next. So now we calculated everything. Let us go with the stresses. Okay, so next, moment due to the net downward load. In earlier case, okay, we used to solve or calculate the moment only for the external load in the stress concept. But in this particular load balancing concept, we need to calculate the moment, okay, for net downward load. Okay, hence I used to call moment due to net downward load, which is equal to M is equal to WL square by. Why? Because it is a UDL. So therefore, which is equal to 16 into 6 square by 8, which is 72 kilonewton meter. So this will be the answer. So we have calculated the moment. So finally, we left with what? The stresses. So those stresses we are going to calculate at mid-span. So please note this. Okay. Therefore, F superior is equal to P by A plus M by ZT. So this is the formula for a load balancing concept. And also you know that P by Z terminology will become zero. Why? Because, okay, eccentricity is zero, or dip of the cable is zero. Okay, and another thing, no eccentric pre-stressing. So let me substitute this. And why it is positive? Because at the top it is positive. Okay, so no, okay, tensile stresses will be created at the top. Hence, F superior is equal to 960 to 10 to the power of 3 divided by 24 into 10 to the power of 4 is the cross-sectional area, plus the moment 72 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 24 into 10 to the power of 6 will get you the answer 7 newton per millimeter square. Next, coming to the F inferior, which is P by A minus M by Z bottom. Here, no need to worry about Z top or Z bottom because it is a symmetrical section. Okay, so this Z top and Z bottom, we need to be very careful when it is unsymmetrical sections. Okay, next, substitute all the entities, okay, just like above, and the final answer will be 1. Okay, so this will be the, so it will be like this. F superior is 7, okay, and F inferior is 1. So this will be the resultant stress distribution. This is 7, okay, and this is 1. So like this, okay, the resultant stress diagram will come into the picture. Okay, so hope the concept has been clear. Okay, so like this, we need to calculate the stresses for a straight profile. Okay, so this is regarding your straight profile, which have been solved in this particular session. Okay, so hope the concept has been clarified. Okay, so I've been worked out one problem on straight profile. Okay, we will continue with this load balancing concept with, okay, another shape or few more shape of the tendon, that is parabolic shape, bent tendon, all those things in the next session. So hope the concept has been cleared. Whatever I have been discussed in this session, I have been discussed, okay, what is load balancing concept and how this load balancing concept will come into picture. And later on, I have started the analyzing the stresses for a PSC beam with the load balancing concept. Okay, I have started with straight tendons or straight profile. Okay, in that I have been worked out one problem, that is subjected to the external UDL. Okay, so this, okay, I'm going to end the session of today. Okay, so we will work out few more problem with few more concept in the next session. Okay, thank you.